Assalamu alaikum. I welcome you to part second of analysis of the sentence. Let me remind you, in our previous lesson, we talked about the subject, verb and the complement. Friends, let's go ahead. Consider the sentence, Alina is writing a letter. Here, Alina is the subject because we are talking about Alina in the sentence. The phrase a letter is the complement as it completes the sentence, and the word writing is a verb because it denotes an action. Now, there remains the word is. What is the significance of the word is in this sentence? In order to understand it, let us compare this sentence with the sentence Alina was writing a letter. Let me tell you, in the first sentence, the word is the present form of the verb be, and in the next sentence, the word was is the past form of the same verb. Now, things have become somewhat clear. The word is tells us that the action of writing takes place in the present, and the word was tells us that the action was taking place in the past. Hence, the word is and the word was tell us about the time of action, or in other words, they mark the tense of expression. Let me tell you, these words that mark the time of an expression or that mark the tense are what we call helping verbs. Hence, the word is in the first sentence and the word was in the next sentence are helping verbs or auxiliaries. Now, does a helping verb always mark the tense of an expression? Let us see. Consider the sentence, Alina can write a letter. Comparing this sentence with the previous sentences, it is evident, it is clear that the word can in this sentence qualifies as a helping verb, but the word can does not mark the tense. It does not tell us about the time, rather it tells us about ability of the person. When we say Alina can write a letter, we mean to say that Alina has the ability to write a letter. Likewise, in the sentence Alina must write a letter, we mean to say that it is necessary that Alina writes a letter. So here, the helping verb can and the helping verb must, they convey special meanings. On the face of it, we will say that helping verbs or words that mark the tense or convey some special meanings. Now, let us go back to the first sentence, Alina is writing a letter. Now, we know that there are two verbs in this sentence. We have the helping verb is, and then we have the verb writing. Let us remember that collectively, a helping verb and a verb constitute what is known as a verb phrase. In a broader sense, a verb phrase is a verb or a verb plus a helping verb. That's all for today. Thank you.